I'm on my way. DJ
Kled.
Yep, it's official. We're taking over. Remix.
If you play League of Legends, there's a chance you've heard one of these sounds before. And it usually means imminent death. In Kled's case, especially so. But before I get into the nitty-gritty of this whole situation, here's my official appeal that we remove Kled as a character name from League of Legends and instead repurpose it as a British insult.
You fucking Kled!
You fucking Kled!
Oi! Kled!
And on another note, Ryan, I'm glad you realized how little you're actually relating to your meme-loving kid player base by calling him the Noxian Meme. I'm very glad you've changed his name to the Cancerous Cavalier. It's quite fitting. Now let Papa Uber sprinkle you with a bit of wisdom. This universe is an infinitely complex organism, and you are not a byproduct of it, you are it. In your day-to-day life, you are what we by definition refer to as God. When you play Kled, however, you are what we by definition refer to as
a piece of shit.
Now I'm gonna go over his kit, and honestly, I don't know why I go over champion kits anymore. Remember when champion abilities used to have like two lines? It's like, he fires a fucking thing and it goes and it damages and slows them. Now when you hover over champion ability, it's like you're being presented with a fucking unsolvable equation for quantum gravity. Seriously, how is this my job right now? I dropped out of high school, yet I'm still forced to study every time I accidentally hover over my passive. Alright, let's try to explain this fucking champion to you. Fuck. So he has this dinosaur that he rides into battle named Skarl. Let me be the first to Photoshop Scarlett Johansson.
Anyways.
Kled and Scarlett each have their own health bar, and Kled doesn't take damage until you kill Scarlett. Kled and Scarlett both have a shit ton of health no matter how you build them, and unless Scarlett is dead, no one in the game can one-shot him, because he has invulnerability frames when he dismounts. He gets to have his mount back when his courage bar is filled, and this is where it gets interesting. Depending on whether you kill an enemy unit or champion, you either get 4 or 20 courage. 4 or 20.
Hold up.
Either way, all you need to know is that this dinosaur comes back pretty fucking often and buffs the fuck out of your health bar. You can also only use one active ability if you don't have the dinosaur, which is his Q, Pocket Pistol, or Bear Trap on a Rope, depending on whether or not Scarlet is alive. If Kled is on his own, he can fire 5 pellets in a cone and shoot himself backwards. He's also the slowest champ in the game without his dinosaur, so you're gonna fucking need this. When he is, however, useful in riding a dinosaur into battle, he throws a bear trap in a straight line. If it hits an opponent and you stay close to them for a bit, it pulls them back to you and it does more damage. His W is just a passive. Thank God I actually get to breathe. Basically, he gets 3 Rengar Qs with extra attack speed and 1 empowered Rengar Q.
As a passive every 8 seconds at rank 5, that also does percentage health damage.
Scaling with AD.
I predict that this will be the first thing they nerf on Kled. His E is like Renekton's E, but better. It's a single dash, but if you hit an opponent, you can reactivate it to fly to them. Like, you know, after they waste flash, or just because it looks fucking cool. This ability is so much fun to use, and you can even use it on their corpses. And finally is all, Riot made the right choice when they named this ability. Because that's what the enemies will scream when they hear. You literally just click where you want to go, and Kled just fucking rolls out like a badass. He also gains a massive shield and movement speed buff that scales with distance traveled. He then locks on to the first champion he gets near and knocks them back and deals damage,
also based on distance traveled, scaling with AD.
Boom! That's all you need to know about Kled's fucking abilities, and it just proves my point. You have no fucking idea what this champion does. The two things you remember vividly are... And maybe if Ryan stopped writing a novel each time they make a passive, my content would be more coherent. Actually, no, I'd probably still just make content. Since I'm a manic psychopath, I also decided to look up Kled porn. I was quite disappointed in our community, as the only stuff I could find was some gay furry shit. Anyways, let me talk about all the things I love about this champion. I hate pussy gameplay. I hate champs that stand still under their turret and wait 15 minutes for their jungler to show up. I hate champs that stand back and perform a magic trick and then poof, your health bar is gone. And Kled's gameplay is the polar opposite of pussy gameplay. This is pure penis ding dong dick gameplay. When your dinosaur dies, you run super fast, but only towards opponent. You're fucking turtle in any other direction. And the only way you can regain your last two abilities and your health bar is by running straight into the enemies and slapping the kunta out of them. I honestly can't imagine anything more aggravating than being on the receiving end of this type of dicking where you're just about to die and then Scarlet whips out a can of whoop-ass, and honestly I just come over my keyboard every time that happens. Fuck! I'd say Kled is easily the best champ Ryan has released since Yasuo. That means he beats all of these champions. I mean, I've only played about half of them, but that should still give you an idea of how fucking awesome I think Kled is. He's the best champ they've released since... Wait, what the fuck? It's almost been 3 years since Yasuo? What? Holy fuck! I mean, first off, what the fuck, in my opinion, is less than a year since he was released. And secondly, Riot have released 15 champions in 3 years? And you're still telling me that LCS budgeting isn't affecting the development of the game? Anyways, back on track. A couple of the things I love about him include, but aren't limited to, the best emote in the game, the second best emote in the game, the wall jump on his Q, his facial expression. This thing is clearly on MDMA, and he's just an overall badass. Sky's Fighter Give Up series has taught me to properly inspect any image. Notice the arrow. He caught a fucking arrow. Don't fight this man.
Give up immediately.
And since I've mentioned all the things I fucking love about Kled, it's time to mention all the things I fucking hate about Kled. First up, you run so fucking slow when you don't have Scarlet. Imagine you're on 420 ping and someone injected an overdose of ketamine into your eyeballs. That's how I describe the excruciating pain of running away from a jungle gank on foot as Kled. His Q is also deceptively slow and easy to dodge, and most champions can just run out of it since you damn near have to enter their danger zone to get the yank off. And finally, he's a fucking lizard riding meme shouting furry midget. I mean, it doesn't get much less intimidating than that. To summarize, let's show you the pros and cons of playing Kled. Pros. He has extremely high damage, he can stay alive no matter what the fuck you build, doesn't run away from fights, he has 2 health bars, rides a fucking dinosaur, his kit is easy to pick up, yet he still has a really high level of mastery, and finally, he's the best champion Riot has released in almost 3 years. Cons. He's a fairy midget, and he's slow as fuck without Scarlet. Conclusion. You're gonna get a mirror match every single fucking game. And I'm gonna give the rare props to Riot. I mean, my biggest complaint about that company has always been that they balance League around the 10 best fucking Asians in the world and not around their average player base. That they develop League around its capabilities as an esport and not as a fun game. Well, I think there's a chance they've listened. You look at champions like Elise, and you know she was definitely balanced around the 10 best players in the world. You look at these last 3 champs and... I just don't see it. I don't see how these characters were designed around the current meta or any extremely high level of play. To me, it just seems like they were designed to be fun to play. Not to play against, don't get me wrong. You'll still get diagnosed with stage 4 terminal brain cancer if you encounter a Kled on the enemy team. But my point is that I'm very satisfied with these last couple champs Riot have released. I'd rather have a champion like this once a year than a fucking Rek'Sai every 2 weeks. And before you rediscover your long lost love with Riot, just remember that they remove Sword of the Occult and Heart of Gold.
But kept Omwrecker. Fucking Omwrecker.
Anyways, there's no one build that works with Kled. You can build him like a Bruiser the way most people do, or you can go full AD. Shit, you can go full health, or just build 6 Omwreckers and run it down mid. If you do, it's prophesized that Tyler 1 will appear in the middle of your bedroom at 2 AM with a bucket of chicken. And if by some dark magic it still hasn't seeped into your negative IQ brain how awesome Kled is, please indulge in this real-life visual representation of what playing Kled is like.
I don't know what I said. I don't remember. He's going like, I don't remember.
Yeah, it's fucking retarded. Enough beating around the bush, though. It's time to rate this cancerous cavalier. As for his looks, wapow! This one hits the nail right on the fucking head. He's got one eye filled with anger. He catches fucking arrows. He rides a fucking dinosaur into battle. And the in-game model actually lives up to the splash art. I'm gonna give the Cancer Cavalier a 10 out of 10. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause. Never did I think a furry midget warrior would make it to a 10 out of 10. No tits, no ass, just pure alpha. Just pure alpha midget. And as for his gameplay, I mean, after reading all his abilities, which basically equates to writing the entirety of pi and dividing by zero, I've come to the logical conclusion that this alpha beast of a dinosaur-riding furry midget deserves a well-rounded out of 10. And finally, for the only score that truly tells you what I actually think of these champions, my personal enjoyment, I'm gonna give Kled 21 Diet Iced Teas out of 22. Should you play Kled? Fuck yeah. Buy Kled, insta-lock, and then indulge in all the fun you'll be sucking out of your opponents once they realize it's their turns to be miserable. All right, now I have enough. Let's go. I can hold it.
Promise being a man.
Holy shit.
What the fuck? Where am I?
Where did you go? Where did you go?
What's happening?
Where are
Where's
you
my guy? Where's my. What?
What?
What the fuck just happened? What the fuck?
What the fuck?
What the fuck just happened?
Where are you? Where did you go?